Russia's infiltration of the US election campaign sent shockwaves through the US. And now its reverberations are being felt by Australia's political establishment.
This is the new frontier of warfare. It's the new frontier of espionage.
The cyber attack that started Tuesday is wreaking havoc across the globe Wednesday, crippling thousands of computers, disrupting operations at ports from Mumbai to Los Angeles, and halting production at a chocolate factory in Australia.
Every second of every day, hackers are hard at work across the globe. In Australia alone, there were 47,000 cyber incidents in 2017. That's 128 a day, 5 every hour. Many of them will be online scams or frauds.
If you think something is a scam, it probably is, so don't respond.
The rest are even more serious.
Please leave your message after the beep.
Finance. Call me as soon as you get this.
It could be hackers holding a company to ransom, blocking access to files until money is paid.
Call me and get this. Joining conference now.
Apparently, there's a malware attack targeting our main.
It's ransomware. They're holding us hostage.
Or stealing staff logon details to access corporate or government systems. Or a denial of service attack designed to effectively shut down a network by overwhelming it with requests.
The Census website was subject to something called denial of service, outsiders blocking traffic. It repelled 3 attacks, but it couldn't stop a 4th, which coincided with both the peak period of Australians trying to log on and the hardware blocking overseas traffic failing.
In just 1 month earlier this year, there were 7,200 denial of service attacks on Australian targets.
Intelligence agencies had a high degree of confidence the attack came from China.
Officially, it's foreign states which have the greatest power to compromise Australian networks.
I can confirm reports that the Bureau of Meteorology suffered a significant cyber intrusion, which was first discovered early last year.
Cybercrime costs the economy more than $1 billion a year. And the government says malicious activity is becoming more frequent, more sophisticated, and more severe. 1 in 4 small businesses have been hit, but big business often has the most to lose, along with major institutions. And many are vulnerable, running obsolete technology which can't be updated or patched to address a weakness. Last November, 41% of critical systems at Victoria Police and 4 key state government departments were labelled obsolete by the state's Auditor General. And Victoria is not the only state using outdated technology. So what happens if operators lose control of a power grid or hospital staff can't access patient records? Hackers can launch a large-scale strategic attack within minutes. It's happened overseas, and it could happen here. Tonight, in our hypothetical cybersecurity crisis, it will.